In this video, we are going to execute about the life cycle of a servlet. Under the D, already servlets folder is created. So under this, let us create a web application with the name life cycle servlet application. Life cycle servlet application. This is our application name, web application name. So under this folder, we have to create the applications. So under this, first we have to create an HTML file. Let name of the HTML file is index dot. So this is HTML file, index.html. Yes. Next we have to create web INF folder. Web INF should be in uppercase letters. Web-INF in uppercase letters. So this is the structure of a servlet. Under web-INF, we have to create a web.xml file. Web.xml file is called as a deployment descriptor file. We will see what is web.xml while typing web.xml file. And under web-INF, we have to create two more folders. Classes folder is very, very important. Classes folder. So this is nothing but the structure of the servlet. Now go to lifecycle servlet application. Write the code in index.html. So open with notepad. Open with notepad. Here our target is just to create a form with one button. If you click on that button, then it has to go to web.xml file and display some message, such as hello from the lifecycle servlet. Okay, that is our target. So now let us create a form. We know that HTML form starts with HTML tag. Next, here head is not needed. Just body is enough here. Body. So under the body, we are creating a button. So button means we have to create a form. So form action is equal to, under this action, we have to specify URL pattern. This URL pattern will be specified in servlet. In web.xml file, we have servlet mapping element. In servlet mapping, we have URL pattern is there. There we have to specify this URL pattern. So form action is equal to /hello. Hello. Next, close that less than symbol, greater than. Next, under the form, create one button. Input type is equal to, in order to create the button, we use a submit option. Input type is equal to submit. Value is equal to value. Value means that content will get printed. Input type is equal to submit. Value is equal to invoke lifecycle servlet. So here we are creating lifecycle servlet. In order to execute that lifecycle servlet, we have to click on the button. Okay. Input is an empty tag element. So forward slash greater than symbol. So next to close the form tag element, form. Next to close the body tag element, close the body tag element. Next to close the HTML tag element, close the HTML tag element. Next to save the program, control S. So saving is over. Next, let us run the program once. Invoke lifecycle servlet. So this is our form. Our form contains one button. If we observe this one, here we got the message as index.html. Under D, we have servlet folder. Under servlet folder, we have created lifecycle servlet application folder. Under this, we have index.html. If you click on this button, then if you observe this one, here we have /hello. So that hello is nothing but URL pattern. That URL pattern should be specified in web.xml file. So now we have to go to web-INF folder and write the code for web.xml file. Web.xml file is called as deployment descriptor file. Let us open in notepad, open with notepad. Here web.xml file, in web.xml file, the root element is web app. So web app specifies that we are creating web application. We are creating web application. So close the element. Less than slash web app. Web app. Next, web app mainly contains two elements. The first element is servlet element. The first element is servlet element. Close the servlet element. Servlet element mainly contains two child elements. So servlet has two child elements. The first child element is servlet name. So what is the name of the servlet? This is our example one. So I am giving it as example one, ex1. Next, close the tag element, less than slash servlet name. Simply we have to open the tag and close the tag with precedes with slash symbol, servlet name. Next, we have to specify servlet class. So which servlet class we have to execute? Which servlet class we have to execute? So till now servlet class is not created. Let us assume that name of our servlet class is lifecycle servlet. So LCSR uppercase letters. Lifecycle servlet. Close the servlet class element. Close the servlet class element. Next, close servlet element. So servlet element mainly contains two things. The first one is name of the servlet, as well as second one is which servlet class it has to be executed. And it has one more element, that is servlet mapping element. Web app mainly contains two elements. The first element is servlet. The second one is servlet mapping. Servlet mapping. Servlet mapping mainly contains two elements. The first element is servlet name. Here, what is the servlet name here? EX1 is nothing but servlet name. So copy this one, Control C, and paste here. And paste here. Control V. Okay. Next, here we have to specify URL pattern. Already we have created index.html. In that file we have given action value as, what is the action value we given? Hello. That pattern we have to specify here. URL pattern means it starts with forward slash, and we have given action attribute value of the form tag as hello. So let us give as hello. It is our choice. We can give any name here. So less than slash URL pattern, URL pattern. Okay. Next, close the servlet mapping tag element. Close the servlet mapping tag element. Next, close the web app element. So already web app is already created. Let us save this program once. So save this program once. So after saving, just we have to just open with web browser in order to check whether the syntaxes are correct or not. If the syntaxes are correct, then the same document will get opened. If the syntaxes are not correct, then that servlet name will get printed, like EX1, that information will get printed. So open with Internet Explorer. So we got the output. So it specifies that our output is correct. So here what will happen is, whenever we start the server, so first what will happen is control goes to the index.html. This pattern will be specified here. This pattern here, what is the pattern? Hello. This pattern will be specified in web browser. So whenever we click on the button, invoke lifecycle servlet button, then the server will checks for what is the action value. Here, what is the action value? Hello is the action value. So web container will goes to web.xml and it will searches where slash hello is there. So it will search, it will goes to the servlet mapping tag and it will searches where slash hello is there. Okay. Here we have URL pattern. What is the URL pattern? Slash hello. So what is the corresponding servlet name? EX1. So web container will searches for the servlet name with EX1. Okay. So it will searches all the servlets with the servlet name EX1. So here we have only one servlet. That servlet name is EX1. So what is the corresponding servlet class? Lifecycle servlet. So now the web container or web server will execute lifecycle servlet. So the flow will comes from that HTML form to web.xml file. Web.xml file will gives this servlet class. Now servlet class will get executes. So now we have to create the servlet class. So webinf, under this we have classes folder. Under classes folder we need to create the file. So after that we have to compile the file. So once compilation is over, we'll get the class file. So classes folder is mainly useful in order to store the classes. Once the compilation is over, then we will get class file. So in order to store the classes, we are using the classes folder. Let us create a program for the servlet lifecycle. So import space java x dot servlet dot star semicolon. This is the first statement. Why? Because in this example, we are using a servlet interface. Servlet interface is available in java x dot servlet dot star. Next, java dot io dot star. In this example, we are using printwriter class. Printwriter class is available in io package. Next, let us declare the class, public class. Already we have given the class name as lifecycle servlet in web.xml file. Let us give that name, public class lifecycle servlet. And here we are creating the servlet by implementing the interface, by implementing the servlet interface, implements servlet. Servlet interface mainly contains 5 methods. Let us define those 5 methods. So private. So first we have to define the servlet config object. So servlet config. Let name of this one is SC. Servlet interface mainly contains 5 methods. Let us define the first method, public void init. Init method accept servlet config as the parameter. So servlet config. Let name of the object is config. Init method is mainly useful for initialization purpose. If we want to write some database connection code, that should be written here. In this example, we don't have any database connection code. So simply perform the initialization as sc is equal to config. Sc is equal to config and display some information. System.out.println. System.out.println. Init method is useful for initialization purpose. Okay. Let us display some message as in init method, in init method. So this message will get printed in the server console. We will see while execution. So init method is over. Now let us define the next method. The next method is service method. Service method is useful for writing the logic. How many times init method will get executed? Only once. Whereas service method executes multiple times. That depends upon the number of requests. Service method accepts 2 parameters. The first parameter is servlet request. It has 2 objects, 2 parameters. Servlet request parameter. Servlet request is interface. req is an object. Next one is servlet response. Servlet response. Let it object is res. Next to throws. In service method, we are writing the logic. In order to display some result to the user, we are using printwriter method. Printwriter method is available in the we are using printwriter class. Printwriter class is available in the IO package. So when we are using the print IO package classes or interfaces, then we must handle the exception. That means we have to write the body within try catch, or we need to throw that exception. Otherwise it will displace an exception. So throws IO exception, display some message to the user like printwriter. In order to display the message, we are creating an object for the printwriter. We are creating an object with the help of the getWriter method. GetWriter method is available in servlet response interface. Okay. So what is the method now? Out. Out is the object. Okay. So we are using printwriter class. Object name is out. In order to create the object, we are calling getWriter method on the response object. GetWriter method is available in servlet response interface. Next, out dot. In order to display the message, we have println method in the printwriter class. Out dot println. Let us display some message. Hello. Hello from. So what is the application name? Hello from lifecycle servlet. So we have here, our target is we want to provide this information as the response to the client. So this is the second method. Next method is destroy method. Destroy method doesn't accept any parameters. Destroy method is mainly useful for destroying the object. For closing the connections, we use this one. Let us display some message like system.out.println. System.out.println. What is the name of the method in destroy? Just we are displaying some message. In destroy. Next, close the right parenthesis. So this is the third method. we have two more methods are there. Fourth method of the servlet interface is servlet config. It returns servlet config object. So servlet config. Name of the method is get servlet config. Get servlet config. Get servlet config. Get servlet config returns servlet configuration object. Here, what is the servlet configuration object? What is the servlet configuration object? SC. Already we have taken servlet config SC. So return SC. Okay. And the last method is get servlet info. Get servlet info. It returns some strings such as what is the information about the servlet. Get servlet info such as what is the name of the servlet or what is the, who is the developer, what is the version of the web server we are using. The details we can provide. So return, it returns string. String means we have to enclose within the double quotations. Just I am returning some hi. Next to close the method, next to close the class. Next we have to save the program. So what is the name of the class? Public lifecycle servlet. Lifecycle servlet. So control C. So file, save as, control V. What is the extension? What is the extension? .java. .java. So saving is over. So now the structure is created. So lifecycle under the D we have servlets folder. Under servlets we have lifecycle servlet application. Under this we have webinf and index.html. Under the webinf we have classes folder and web.xml file. Under the classes we have lifecycle servlet.java. I am copying this path. Why? Because next we need to compile the program. Let us compile the program. Cmd command prompt. Next we have to move to D because under D only we have the files. So cd space. Next copy the entire path. So cd space classes. Okay. So now it is navigated to D servlets lifecycle servlet application webinf classes. So under this we have lifecycle servlet class. So Java C, compile that program. Java C lifecycle servlet.java. So compilation is over. There are no errors, but we should not execute from here. Why? Because servlet doesn't contains any main method. So in order to perform the execution, we have to start the server. So before that, in order to execute this program, we need to have servlet-api.jar. So that was already set in the class path of the corresponding environmental variables. Just let us go through that once. Advanced system settings, environmental variable. Here we have class path, some user variables. If we observe this one, so this is for some MySQL. If we observe this one, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat 9.0, lib servlet-api.jar. So already this path was set in the my computer environmental variables or user level variables so that we can access servlet interface. So before executing this program, please set the class path for servlet-api.jar. Okay, then only we can perform the execution. So now execution is over. So now we have to deploy the application. We have to place this application in the web server. So copy this one, control C, control C. So I copied this application. Now we have to place this application in the web apps folder of the web server. That process is called as deployment. So in my system, in C, next to program files, next Apache Software Foundation. I'm using Tomcat 9.0 version. My web server is Tomcat 9.0 version. Java is some JDK 1.8 version. Okay. Next, under Tomcat 9.0, we have web apps folder is there. In web apps folder, we have to place that application. Paste here. This is called as deployment. Deployment means placing the web application in the server. Then after that, here we have lib folder. In lib folder, all the jar files are available. Here we have servlet-api.jar. This is useful for using the servlet interface and servlet related classes like generic servlet, HTTP servlet. Next here we have OJDBC14.jar. It is useful for using the database connections like if you want to connect with Oracle database, we need OJDBC14.jar. Okay. So that is about lib. Next, in order to start the server, we have to click on the bin. Under the bin, we have tomcat9.exe. This is some application. So click on this one so that the server will get started. Yes. So now the server got started. Now we have to send the request to the server. In order to send the request to the server, just I am opening the Google Chrome. Let us send a request here. Localhost colon 8080. 8080 is nothing but port number of the Tomcat server. Okay. Under this here we have three buttons are there. Server status, manager app, host manager. Click on the manager app. Next we have to provide username and password. For my system, the username is Tomcat, username is admin. Tomcat password is admin. Already it was given. So click on the sign in button. Then we will get applications like this. In WebOps, a list of applications are there. What is our application name? Our application name is Lifecycle Sublet Application. So click on Lifecycle Sublet Application. If you click on Lifecycle Sublet Application, then directly this HTML page displayed. HTML page contains a form with one button. So whenever we click on this button, then what will happen? Control goes to the web.xml file. Here in the form, we have given action as /hello. So it goes to the servlet mapping. In servlet mapping, we have URL pattern is there. In one of the URL pattern, we specified /hello. For that, the corresponding servlet name is ex1. So the web container or web server goes to the servlet with the servlet name ex1. And the corresponding servlet class will get executed. What is the servlet class output? Hello from lifecycle servlet. So we got this message here. Okay. If we open the server, so already server was opened. So this is nothing but server. Here we got the message in init. The statement was given in the init method. So likewise, we have given destroy also. If we close this window, if we stop the server, then what will happen is here in destroy method.